After Greynature found some success in their new lottery mechanic, they started to experiment with different ways to utilize this power, and while doing so, they transformed into a more human-like form of themselves, and with that, they found a way to unleash its full potential. Holy Great Sage of Black Shadows, Isabelle, is the new main unit that allows Greynature to tap into the full potential of the lottery mechanic. Isabelle and her assistant introduce a fresh wave of lottery units into the clan, but not only that, they empower the tigers from the Leopold school. Isabelle's main ability allows you, the moment your opponent is also sitting at grade 3 or greater Vanguard, to get both effects of every lottery ability, meaning those abilities will become twice as strong as you effectively get two skills for the cost of one. And to complement that passive ability, Isabelle also has her own lottery effect. The moment she enters the field, for the cost of a Soul Blast, you either get to increase her with 15k power if you mill a normal unit, or you get to fetch the milled card to hand if it's a trigger. If you combine this with the moment you ride her when your opponent is also at grade 3, you get a plus 1 and you get a 27k Vanguard. Isabelle turns already very powerful units into insanely valuable engines that can outvalue almost any deck out there in an equal 1-for-1 trade. Isabelle on her own won't change a lot, but her effect is best seen when looking at her assistants and students. Scientist of Black Sheen Matilda is either a Battledore unit or a 2-crit attack. On its own, isn't that great unless you use her as your Vanguard unit, as both outcomes can be pretty strong as a Vanguard attack when supported by the right cards. But combined with Isabelle, you have a double crit Battledore unit, and then suddenly we have the best of both worlds, as both effects complement each other so well. Prop of Black Jet Cecile is either a free 13k unit or a double cycle for the cost of a Soul Blast. You rather have the cycle, especially in the early game, but the fact that it can refund itself is pretty nice. But when we have Isabelle, then it's suddenly a free 13k unit and a double cycle. That's when we're talking about value. Isabelle's influence doesn't stop with her students, she also affects the school of Leopold, as we can see with Binoculus Tiger. Now for a single counterblast, we get a draw, a retire, and we give free units 5k power, which is insane value for a single counterblast. Binoculus Tiger combined with Isabelle shuts off PGs and forces your opponent to guard with triggers. If we combine it with Matilda, then we can force a lot of shield value from our opponent while we have other strong attacks standby to overrun our opponent. This isn't the only support we can find in Greynature, as we can even found comrades within the Hemskase family. Hemskase Rifle Rocket Pencil Hamdan is a perfect supporter for Isabelle, as most cards use a soul. This card allows us to refill that resource, as at the same time cycle and give more power onto the field. Also, Hemskase's rival Red and Blue Pencil Hamhiko is a great card for the deck. Not only do we get a solid early game control draw engine, it also is a nice beater that synergizes with the rest of the deck, including himself. With all these draw, mills, and cycles, we go through our deck quite quickly, so we need ways to close the games before we go deck out, and that's where this little buddy comes into play. Solution Tenric is a nice finisher that can close games once we start hit a significant amount of cards in our drop zone, as it's very likely that your opponent already used most of the triggers for your other insane attacks. Greynature has a big resource issue, as they don't have any counter charges, and a lot of skills also focus on soul blasting, meaning you're limited in the amount of abilities you can resolve. Luckily for us, Isabelle makes those resources have double the value, making it possible to meet ends due. Greynature also has a lot of free abilities that they can fall back on to keep the ball rolling. But it's very important to understand that your resources are limited and that you don't overextend too soon, as that can cost you the game before it even began. The trigger lineup is a very flexible one. Both crits and fronts have a good reason to be run depending on your build choices. Do you have strong, solid beaters? Then crits might be better. But if you are more akin to swarm the field, then fronts have much, much more value. The only advice that I have is to refrain yourself from running more draws outside of the draw PGs, as the deck is already pretty fast paced in going through cards. Having more draws can in fact have a negative effect on the build's performance. As for gift markers, it's basically the usual story. Both markers have their merits and can be used for various reasons. But just like draws, keep in mind the amount of cards in deck when going for Axel 2. Usually when diving into different lists, we have 3 lists to cover, but this time we only have 2 lists to present. one box list and one full power lottery build. This has to do with the fact that Great Nature didn't get enough support to really expand and make big differences between builds. Also, a big portion of the support went to a sub-archetype, making the choices even more limited. With that said, let's dive into the Isabelle build that we can make straight out of the Mysterious Fortune set. This list might surprise you as we don't run Mari Martin, and that is because we already have plenty of units that use Soul and Counterblast. We replaced him with Hamden as he can give us Soul and at the same time make our columns big. The rest of the list is your typical list where we run the various lottery cards and Hamden and Hamhiko for consistency. But we also see some new faces as we have Art Club member Paranoir. This card can help us in those dicey situations where we're almost deck out and we can't attack with our Vanguard or we can't activate another mill ability. This way we can reload the deck with a couple of extra cards. Another new unit is Skill Toucan. This card can be a solid booster and attacker for the deck, but it also allows us to reuse on place ability. So if we want to call certain cards in the early game, then we can still reuse them during the Isabelle turn to get the full potential going. And we can also use Solution Tenric as an early game beatstick and then rebounce him to the Axel Circle the moment we can use him. The main strategy of the deck is to go into Isabelle so your lottery units are on full power. Then go through the deck while putting your opponent under pressure with Matilda and Hamhiko, as well as Hamden, and finish the game with Solution Tenric. Hamhiko, together with Skill Toucan, can create a solid 27k column, the same number is as Isabelle herself. Incidentally, you can make any rearguard Isabelle hit 42k on an Axel 2 if you combine her with Hamden. Speaking of, use Hamden to not only give loads of power to the field, but use him to fill the soul with your other powerful cards that use the soul for powerful card effects. We can see the basic power of Isabelle within this support wave, but if we want to invest into the lottery mechanic, we need to look back at the Tiger support and combine them with this engine and thus create this deck. This deck has everything that contains or supports the lottery mechanic. We can see the Isabelle cards, the Leopold cards, and even the general support. And we top it off with two copies of Solution Tenric for the late game finisher. Leopold in this build is basically our backup right target in this scenario if we can't go into Isabelle. But he's also great in the scenario where we lost our field or when we run out of resources. This way we can still get value out of our units. The overall game tactic is very similar to the previous build, only now we have more units that uses resources as we have these that uses Counterblast and these that uses Soul. So be very careful with them. The best situation to activate your skills is to wait with most of your skills once your Isabelle is live, but you might not always have that luxury, so time your skills right. Isabelle makes Great Nature cards a lot more powerful and brings the lottery mechanic to a new level, which with new support will only become stronger. But as you have seen, the deck itself doesn't have inherent combos or strategies. The deck itself is mainly about knowing when to and when to not activate certain skills. Also, even though we only feature two decks lists, doesn't mean you can't build different lists. As just stated, the deck isn't about intricate combos, it's about knowing when to do something. And with that, you can swap in different cards. Think about cards like Barcode Zebra, Tank Mount, Geograph Giant. There are other strong cards that can be used that can help with your personal playstyle. Great Nature are becoming the masters of their own destiny, but not in the same way as Gear Chronicle. Learn what it means to walk between two realities and have Lady Luck always on your side. Thanks for watching this deck spotlight for Isabelle for Great Nature. If you're interested in more content, then you can check out this deck spotlight for Agravain for Gul'Pennon, or stick around as we're diving right into the Neo Nectar deck spotlight for Oboros Dragon. As always, this video has been brought to you by our lovely patrons over at Patreon. You guys are amazing. If you do want to support the channel or everything that's happening on the channel, then you can simply head over to patreon.com/vanguardinsider and become a patron today. But with that said, I'm Mr. Timely, and I see you guys in the next one!